If you do live streaming on YouTube, you have two options to choose from: Stream Now and Events. Live events have several advantages. Your scheduled stream will appear on your channel page, which will attract more attention. People who are interested can set a reminder. And most importantly, you have a unique stream link, which you can share on social media to create buzz. Let's get started with setting up a live event. In the Creator Studio, we go to Live Streaming, then Events, and click Schedule a new event. Now you can enter metadata like you do for all of your videos. What is special here is that you need to enter a scheduled start date for your stream. By the way, you can always reschedule your event later on. Alright, let's add a description and some tags. Then you should set it to public right away. This is important if you want to show the event on your channel page. And finally, you can choose the type. I use custom so that I can stream with OBS. In the advanced settings, you can define when to show your event on your channel page. I prefer 1 week in advance. Since most of the new subscribers I'll be getting visit my channel page, I hope to catch more viewers for that stream that way. Okay, other settings worth mentioning is this checkbox. Keep it unchecked if you want to make the replay available. Check it if you want to hide the replay, then only people who have the link to your stream will be able to watch your replay. Additionally, you may consider to use low latency. This way you can interact better with your audience in the chat. However, this needs a good internet connection. My trick is to use a network cable, not Wi-Fi. That makes a big difference. Alright, let's create the event. Next, you can upload a thumbnail. Do that like you do for all of your videos. It's important. Finally, choose what kind of stream key to use. I didn't try the reusable stream key yet. The single-use stream key works fine. Before every stream, I just give OBS the new key. I'll show you in a minute how to do that. Okay, great, the setup is done. Now let's go to my channel page to make sure the event shows up there. For that, we need to customize the layout and add a section. We select upcoming live streams here. This section will then show up if you have scheduled some live events that you chose to promote on your channel page. And of course, I want this section to be at the top so that my new subscribers get to see it. Okay, next up, let's go to the live event page. The live stream will take place here. And before it has started, people can set a reminder. This is super helpful because if you have an international audience, they don't even have to wonder about time zones. They see the right start time wherever they are. Now you are ready to create buzz around your stream. Just click share and use the link to post on social media or to send an announcement to your email list. Remember, this link will also allow people to watch the replay if they missed the stream. This is super useful. Yes, all done. Now you may wonder how you can actually stream when the time arrives. Let me walk you through using OBS. For testing purposes, I set the event to private. Feel free to do that too if you want to do a test run. Then go to ingestion settings and grab the stream key. Go to OBS, open the settings, and in the stream section you can paste the stream key. Alright, now it's time to start streaming. Go to the live control room. At this point, YouTube is not receiving any data. Just go to OBS and click Start Streaming. You can see now that OBS is sending data to YouTube. In the live control room, you can also see now that the stream status is good. Now click Preview to let YouTube prepare your stream. Then click Start Streaming, and then you are live. By the way, at the bottom you can find the chat, which you can pop out so you can easily follow the chat while you are streaming. Okay, once you are done, just click Stop Streaming on the YouTube page. And after that, stop streaming in OBS. Alright, that's it. At this point, YouTube is already preparing the replay of your stream. You don't have to do anything. I hope this helps with your streaming. Let me know if you have any further questions. Cheers, my friends!